My name is Jeff Wigman. I'm a painter in Troy, New York. This is one of a rolling series of paintings that I started about 5 years ago that are done spontaneously, really without a plan. And they tend to be monochrome because of that. I like to simplify the design so that I can do it just on the spot. And this was a way of mimicking or following my ink sketches. So the way I draw is often just in a very watery medium that comes together, and as it sort of firms up, it becomes an image. And so I started working with paintings the same way. This was done without any idea of an image or a design in mind. It changed a lot from its original kind of first stab. And over time, as it builds, it announces itself about what it's supposed to be. And so instead of depicting an image or deciding on what it's going to be and then rendering it as if it's just an image, it's more of a process of watching something evolve with my participation and the materials kind of in conjunction with each other. So it becomes this sort of working meditation in a landscape form. So it's a way of seeing one's mind as you work arise and manifest in this way. This isn't my idea. This is kind of a very old idea. And you see it a lot in Chinese painting and romantic painting of the 18th and 19th century. You have a big space, and then you have a little figure. So it's this quality of first relating to this sort of open, spacious quality of painting. It's like what you see first. And then with that in mind, you can then start piecing together like, the structure of the form, of what's in it, what kind of rocks are the buildings in it. And so it's almost like if you walk into a party and you first just start, the door opens and you're just there in the party, and then you start seeing, oh, there's the bar and there's some couches, and then you start seeing like who you might want to talk to. So there's this very organic process of how we apprehend, how we piece together the world, and this kind of painting, it lends itself to that. So first, the space was established, and I started to figure out, like, what is this I'm relating to? This used to have mountains, but I took them out because it was really just the space I wanted to deal with. And then slowly, I decided on some forms, and then at the end, there's this moment where you need to animate it with some kind of figure. And so in Chinese painting, for instance, you'd see a giant sky with a big mountain and then little houses and then a fisherman standing in the net or something. And so with this, I added a dog. Dogs are sort of less culturally leaning than humans, so I put a little dog in there. Are there any questions?
Do you ever add a figure? I mean, I follow what you're saying, but do you ever start with a larger figure and a subservient space in a sense?
I think that, or I'll start with the figure, something in mind, something, an image I want to make. But then I want to put them in space really quickly. So it's always about working with some kind of tutorial space. But I think that's what we see first. And that's what we react to when we look at images. first, unless it's just all figure. But I don't generally do that.
Do you find that as you begin the painting, it feels like a more abstract process in your mind in terms of, you know, just something that you're doing to a canvas to establish sort of something and then make it more representative as you go?
Yeah.
Your intention is to essentially work in an abstract sort of pull that away, and then you start to render the individual forms. And do you know kind of the point where you're going to stop? Like when is there, you know, when you get to a point where you feel as though there's enough detail, or there's, you know, this is probably the eternal question for the artist. This type of work is just this very, it's you know, it's very clear that it has restraint. It doesn't get too bogged down in detail.
Mm-hmm.
It still leaves an impression.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that's definitely a concern. So they do just start. Often they start with just a sense of movement. Like I have, you know, a light and a dark, and I just start with like, what is this going to mean? And so first I can just relate to the blank space or the canvas, intentionally just stand there with it, and then something emerges, and there's often just a kind of indication or a slight hint of like what direction this would be, and it's like you put a tiny mark down, and then you respond to that, and then you respond to that. And so it kind of built itself very naturally. Like when a cat like just it tickles a little string.
Which is a little.
And then a little more, and then it's like rolling on the ground and the string.
Yeah.
It's like that. But then you do have to decide like when do you stop and when is it when am I just kind of like trying to render something? I usually
when it starts to look like something possibly, or it starts to have too much form, is kind of when you want to use it.
I don't mind working with form, and the dog's pretty.
Right, I would almost call that an end point in terms of the whole thing. Is okay, this huge space, and then you punctuate it almost.
Yeah, I think there's always a balance, and there's always a moment where I realize that I'm just not looking at the whole anymore. I'm just kind of like trying to get something right. And that's where I really just kind of like scrape it off.
Yeah, that's interesting. So you had posted about this on Instagram, and you hashtag turn, because this is very much influenced by his work.
Yeah.
What made you, I don't know if I missed this in the beginning, I apologize if I'm coming back around to it, but what about this work and the work he has, which is very similar but without the dog, what made you want to pay homage to that piece in particular?
Well, he was working with a lot of the same ideas. He was working with the volumes of light, and creating spaces in which light dynamics were being affected and pulled and pushed and bouncing off of five different things and five kinds of light hitting one object, and all of these qualities that come out through the work itself. So I've always looked at his method and the way he layered things. And interestingly, the way he would lay out a painting, he would start with the space. So he would use rags and basically fill out the color space of the painting, and then he'd put a structure in it, and then he would populate it and finish it with details. So I think that this process was very sort of ingrained in the way we perceive, that first there's this general impression, and then we figure out the structure, and then we can move into that. So it's really a way of kind of looking at how the mind unfolds moment to moment.
I mean, the energy in this piece and the energy in your other pieces are quite different, because it is about light, but it's also about story. And so this is a piece that I haven't, like, I've seen many of your pieces, and I've seen some of the stories that you tell through your pieces, or some of the stories you want to pull from your pieces. And this one is different, and it is a dog, right?
Yeah.
I just remember looking at it and thinking, feeling that power from something outside of us, you know, trying to push it through. But that's just my interpretation of your piece, so I really enjoyed it.
Thank you. Really enjoyed it too. It's got such a great drama to it, and the dog just, I mean, you can interpret it in many different ways, but to me it almost looks like he's just kind of going along his way, and he doesn't even notice this like menacing orb of light. So it's really interesting. I also was wondering, I apologize, I don't know if you said this before, but what your thought process was behind the color scheme, like using these reds and these rich reds. Was there a thought behind that, or were they trying to portray a certain story with the colors?
Not a story, no. Sometimes I'll just I'd want to use just something for its optical effect. So I have you know, this very transparent and deep red that I wanted to work with. That if you lay it over the colors that are already there, then it has this really glowing quality to it.
Wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you,
Jeff.
Thank you.
Thank you.